Hello everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel, Alex here. Now, what do I want to do in this video is talk about the CV and the business attire photos because I didn't do that already and many of you are asking me and I have to do this video. So I became a cabin crew in 2016, right? I joined Etihad Airways in 2016 and since then, I didn't really use my CV, right? Because I didn't have to. So what I will do now is actually present you the photos and the CV that I joined with in 2016. Nowadays, they're a bit different, right? I mean, there's some differences in the requirements and so on and so forth. People know more about CVs. People know more about the way you should do your photos and the way you should present yourself in interviews. So there's more information out there, but still that doesn't discredit what I did in 2016. The fact that I joined with that CV and those photos. So this is what I'm gonna show you now. All right, ladies and gents. So this was my CV in 2016. Which I presented for Etihad Airways for the interview, right? So let's get started right here. This is my picture in the CV. I recommend putting a picture all the time just so you can differentiate yourself and maybe interviewers will remember you. But more so for online interviews nowadays, I think it matters a lot, let's say the CV itself. Because when I tried, when I was in the interview, we were having a CV drop event, right? It was an open day. I went with my CV. I gave it to the interviewers. I smiled to them. Hey, this is me. Hi, my name is Alex. I'm from this city and I'm 22 years old back in time, right? Back there. It was a CV drop event. Nowadays, it's online. So the CV probably matters even more so than it mattered when I was there because let's say if your CV wasn't up to par, then you have your, I don't know, attitude at the interview, you have your smile and stuff like this, right? It's a presentation as well. Curriculum vitae right here. It's a Europass kind of CV, I believe. It's a Europass template. It's a very simplistic CV. Personal information. Now, this is very important. Always first name and surname. You have to put your details here. So personal information and a work experience are the basic things that you should have in every CV because your interviewer wants to know, okay, what's his number, what's his email and all these things and where has he worked before. My email was there, right, date of birth. I put these brackets here just because I don't want to share my personal information with you guys, with all due respect. But yeah, nationality, date of birth right here, 1993, it's the year I was born. As you guys know, I'm 28 right now. Gender and work experience. So this is actually my work experience. So right now I'm sharing my work experience with YouTube. So that's it, right? I was doing a hostessing event. That was before I joined Etihad. I was basically doing weddings in which I was the guy waiting at the door, right? And I was walking you to the your table and so on and so forth, and customer service with the wedding guests, basically. That's what I was doing before. I worked as a waiter in a pool bar. That was in a very nice hotel back in Greece, in Halkidiki. It was amazing. It was a good summer. It was a summer job. Another job was a marketing agent. I was basically selling contracts for a radio station. And then I was a sales assistant at Bershka, which, you know, Bershka and Zara, probably you know about this company. Probably you buy clothes from there from time to time. So it's, yeah, I worked there for a year, I think, almost a year. And my first job ever, ladies and gents, my first job ever was in a factory for 2 months, right? I was, or 2 or 3 months. I was 18, I wanted a job, so I just went to this factory and hey, hire me, I'll work here, so that's it. I was making knits and screwing pieces of furniture together for 9 hours per day. It was tough and I was earning like very little money. But you know, it was the first job, right? Even now, like if I do manual labor, if even now, I don't care, like it's not a big deal. Manual labor is not a big deal. But anyway, apart from this, for Etihad Airways and for cabin crew jobs in particular, what really matters is customer service jobs. So that's what I put here because that's what I had as well. Waiter, right? Marketing agent, sales, right? Event host. Amazing. Three things that are really, really important. So those are examples also of those are examples also of customer service oriented jobs. Let's go further, education and training. This is the third part of the CV. Now, the problem with the CV is that it's quite cluttered. There's a lot of informations that maybe are too much. Maybe I put too many things in this CV. That's at least right now, that's what I'm noticing about my own CV. But anyway, education and training. Those are the dates, 2008 and 2012. Those are my high school years. So I wrote here baccalaureate, high school diploma. That was at the end, I got the diploma after my 4 years of high school. And this was my average right here, 9.28. I did okay in high school, I did okay in middle school. Like I was always doing my homeworks, I was learning, I was passing tests all the time, you know, with high degrees. So I don't know, I think it's important, right, for the future and stuff like that. So anyway, the average I have here, 9.28, this was the average between the final exams and the whole 4 years. So in Romania, this is how it is. You take the final exam and then you take the 4 years and the both degrees combine into one. So this was my average. And then some skills here, English, sports, and then dates, 2012 to 2016. That was my university diploma. So I've done college, I've done tourism, the faculty of geography, tourism and sport. The section was geography, tourism. That's what I did. And it was done in English language. So I actually did my college in English language in Romania. This sounds weird. It doesn't really happen usually, but yeah, in Romania, we have sometimes classes in English. At least this one was, so that's why I went for it. And I don't know if I speak better English because of it, but you know, as I said before, English is all around you. If you take a look, if you want to improve your skills, you can do it. Personal skills and awards. So here are just stuff that I did. And when I said I put too many things in my CV, I think I was referring to this. There's definitely a lot of things here. Network marketing skills. I was a sort of a public speaker and a leader for that company. I mean, I was just basically an affiliate, right? And I was trying to make sales. It's called network marketing. You can search it. You can look into it. It's good for your skills in speaking and sales. That's for sure. And I put here some prizes that I had in some computer things when I was younger. And I put European Youth Parliament. I had three trips with European Youth Parliament, and they were based upon environmental things. Save water, save future, reduce, recycle, whatever. So I went to those three places. It was all sponsored by European Youth Parliament, and it's pretty cool. We traveled, you know, we were young, we were drinking and everything, right? We were just having fun, and also at the same time working towards those issues, right? It was we had big groups, and you know, it was like 2 weeks in each one of those places. I was in Prague, in Macedonia, and in Croatia. It was amazing. So as you can see, I try to do extra things apart from just college or from high school. I try to do more, right? I try to travel places. If I get opportunities, I try to take the opportunities. I was always like this, I guess. I try to do more. And then I had some volunteering here, that was with children with disabilities. That's pretty cool. That's a pretty cool thing to do. All right, so first prize diploma, geography, tourism. So my first 1 year and a half, I was first in class in college. That's what it means. I was part of the best 10 athletes in my county. I was third place in the country at a point in athletics. So I just put this here. It's not required. You don't have to put stuff like this in the CV, but I think I was like proud of all of those things and I wanted to put as much in my CV as possible. So that's why I put it there. Basically, I was good in athletics. That I have an athletic background. That's why gym now is easy for me to gain muscle or all these things, because I was always an athlete, right? I was always into sports. So I guess that's really important. Okay, mother tongues, Romanian, again, you have to write all those things down. It's better to have them written. Other languages, English, advanced user. As you can see, I'm not that bad in English. And then French, basic user. Why did I put French there? Because I did French in high school and middle school. And to be honest, right now, if you ask me things in French, I don't know if I can reply to you. But I do understand French and I can read French as well. So I guess that counts a little bit. Still, if you cannot speak a language at all, you shouldn't put it there, but anyway. Social skills and competences. Outgoing personality, I enjoy traveling. So just, I put a bit of clutter there. Maybe it's too much. Again, right now I don't really agree with all this. Things. Multinational work, delegation for European Youth Parliament, Youth in Action, as I said before, I did that. Customer service, okay. Organizational skills. So I just wrote a few things about me. I'm a good organizer, developing great skills in communication with other people, and a team builder. Computer skills and competences, European Computer Driving License, Core Certificate, ECDL, this is how it's called. So basically, Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Access, Publisher, those Microsoft things, right, that all of us use. We all know how to use them, but I have a degree for them for some reason. I guess it counts. I don't know. It's good to have this in the CV for any job, right? If not only for airlines, but for any other job, it's good to have those kind of things because, you know, you can get an office job basically, which requires those. I also have experience with HTML, that's web pages, some skills about how to create the web page, you know, some programming, but very limited. I keep saying I will get into it more, but anyway, I don't have the time. Now, artistic skills and competences, that sounds very weird if I think about it. Modeling, fashion shows and events, that's what I did before as well. As a side gig, I was doing modeling. I did photo shooting, I did catwalking. I presented from suits to underwear, right, on a stage. So it was interesting. It was pretty cool. You know, I had a lot of attention from girls from the start, from teenage years because of this, since I was, let's say, 16, 17 upwards. You know, I was like a model, so that's pretty cool for the girls, right? If anybody did any kind of modeling and things like this, it's very good to put in your CV for a cabin crew job, because obviously, I mean, nobody says they're looking for good looking people, but if you look at the cabin crew many times, you will see good looking people. So I'm not saying anything here. I'm just saying that I guess modeling is a good thing to have in your CV if you ever did modeling. Additional skills and hobbies, fitness and gym, personal hobby, right? Workout 4 to 5 times a week. So ever since I finished with the athletics, I started to go to the gym just to have a nice body. So this is what I'm doing now. Even I'm going to the gym often. So yeah. Driver's license, yes. And overall strengths, communication, customer service, networking, good language skills. Everything. So this is my CV, ladies and gents. This was my CV in 2016. This is crazy, right? And that's about it. That's the CV. Is it perfect? No. Is it what it should be always? No. Is it too complicated or too many things put in there? Maybe. But it has everything that it needs, which is high school diploma. You must have it for a cabin crew job. Then all the personal information, absolutely, you need the personal info in the CV written. Then language skills, you need to put English there and you need to have fluency in English, some kind of fluency in English, right? Then the customer service jobs. Ladies and gents, customer service jobs, even if you don't have one, try to volunteer for one. It's very important, right? And you see it's important because I passed the interview, right? So I would say, yeah, customer service jobs are very important. also any other volunteering kind of thing. That's why I put it here, because I thought at the moment it's super important. All right, as for the pictures, those, ladies and gents, are some pictures which I had. There was shot on different occasions and mainly shot with the blue background. Yes, indeed, blue background. So nowadays you better go for a white background, but depends what the company is asking for you. Like for me, I remember they asked for blue background. I sent those photos by mail, as I remember. So nowadays I keep saying to you guys, just read the requirements and act accordingly. If they send you a mail, if they ask for some pictures, you have to reply in a timely manner and send them the pictures. Now, those are the pictures. So let's see a full length. This is a full length photo of me in 2016 applying for a cabin crew job. I was having a photo shoot on a blue background. Business attire, as you can see, let's zoom in, classical. Hairstyle, I would say it's a bit too much. Maybe it was too big. I have kind of the same hairstyle if you look now. Maybe a bit more fade, a bit more classical. It was not bad, but as you can see, the hair here was a bit too long. Still, I passed, right? It's good. But yeah, classical type of hairstyle. That's what we need, ladies and gents. Not too short, not too long either, right? Classical look. Shorter on the sides, a bit longer here, and nicely folded, right? Nicely put, you know, wavy, whatever. You don't have to come in the interview with the hair all like this, right? Use a comb. Everything, use some gel, whatever you do, do it right. I was smiling all the time in all the pictures. As you can see, I was smiling, right? Smile is important. Have a bright smile. If you have any dental problems, fix them before you take those photos. Fix them before the interview. I had a suit, a dark navy suit, I think, dark blue or something like this. This is the suit. It wasn't the best quality suit. It was an old suit I used to go for church, you know, like I used to use it for church. So I don't know, I wouldn't say it's the best suit, but it served me right. Better any suit than no suit, I guess. But if you can, and if you have the means to buy a nice suit, buy it. It's, I would say, an investment in your interview and in your future. Tie has to be classical. You don't want a tie that's too outlandish or too sparkly. You want a tie that's nice. I had both of my buttons tied up. I don't know if that's good or not, but anyway. A watch on the left hand, a metallic watch. You can do without a watch as well. I wouldn't say it's a requirement, but it's an accessory, right? And it's permitted to have in the photo. Yeah, and black polished shoes. So that is basically me. Now I have more photos here. This is on the white background. It's like a passport photo from the business attire photos. And those are some casual photos. So I just had some casual photos just for the application. Here, 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 and here. Yeah, those are some casual photos in a casual attire, right? Jeans, casual shoes, and a t-shirt. Black t-shirt, that's what I recommend to have, just in case. Yeah, and the same picture you see here, this is another picture. I was smiling in all of my pictures. Don't be afraid to smile. I know many people are like, okay, but I'll do the pictures, I'll do the business attire, but I'll not smile. I'll just smile without my teeth. I don't like to show my teeth. Guys, show your teeth. It's fine. And if you don't have a nice smile, make it, because it's important, right? It's important to have a good smile. If, as I said before, any dental problems, try to fix before those type of photos, before those interviews, because they matter. This is basically it, ladies and gents. As I said, those were my pictures and this was my CV. Now, we discussed a bit more than I wished for. I hope this video will not be too much, too much time. Many of you asked me before about the CV and the photos, so this is my reply to you, ladies and gents, for all of you asking and being curious about how I passed my interview. those are some of the photos, and this is my CV. Again, I'd like to thank you for watching this video. Please leave a like, comment down below if you have any opinions and questions. I'll try to answer them. Until next time, my name is Alex. See you guys on the next one. Yes.